Can I just start by asking you, whose party is in the worst state at the moment? Anyone want to go first?
Should we arm wrestle for it?
I think it's probably true to say that the Conservative Party's got its problems and you think it's disastrous, and then you look at your opponents across the water and realise there's somebody even worse off.
And Chris, do you feel much the same, or do you agree with Graham?
I do, because I think the Conservative thing, there's a process, the process is running, the candidates are in,
there's clarity.
There's a process that's happening, whereas in the Labour Party at the moment, it just feels like chaos.
Peter Carl, your boss, was one of the 172 who signed the motion of no confidence in Jeremy Corbyn.
Yes, he was.
And yet when the Corbyn camp sort of produced their list of who was in, who was out, etc., he was classed as sort of in the middle, as in.
Yeah, I think there was a con called neutral or something. So Peter. Well,
they're not in politically the same place, but Peter's regarded as a sort of.
Peter, from day one with Jeremy Corbyn, the priority for Peter, Peter's very loyal, really loyal. So he was loyal to Jeremy Corbyn, followed the whip. He's never voted against the whip. He's never broke the whip. Tried to support Jeremy. Fast forward 10 months later, though, and especially with the shock of the referendum, which, and Europe is something very, very close to Peter's heart.
Part of the thinking of the party is with the possibility of a general election, of another general election, there is the sort of the desire to be election ready, as it were, just in case.
Absolutely. I think the referendum result has triggered this whole process of thinking about general elections. You know, can the Conservative Party put a new leader in place who will be Prime Minister, voted for by 100,000 members, or will they have to look to the country?
I think the referendum result, I think it's probably the biggest metaphorical punch in the face for the establishment since the advent of universal suffrage. I just think it's incredible that the left in this country seem to be protesting about a supranational bureaucracy, unelected bureaucracy, and siding with the bankers and big business and the establishment against the little people who voted to leave.